Hey folks, it's Lauren from Snowy's here with the Jetboil MiniMo.
Get it.
It's an awesome portable cooking system with excellent simmer control, perfect for lightweight adventures. So whilst these are primarily designed for those lightweight adventurers, hiking, cycling, kayaking, all of that sort of stuff, we have had amazing feedback from our customers, and me included, who takes my MiniMo everywhere with me, that these are an awesome addition for caravanners or four-wheel drivers who want to have a cup of tea or a quick stop, have a hot beverage, don't want to get out their camp stove, don't want to stoke up the fire, things like that. It's a perfect little quick boil stove unit. So all in all, this weighs 400 grams as it comes straight out the packet. It measures 16 centimeters tall and about 12 and a half centimeters in diameter. Now, what it comes with is the lid. So you have your gas canister support, which tips nicely into the lid here. That opens up like so, and we'll take a range of different sized gas canisters, which clip on to it. We've got a little microfiber bag in here, which has our pot support, which comes with the MiniMo. So this is a separately available Jetboil accessory that does come with the MiniMo. And we also have our little burner shroud. So this little chamois bag or microfiber bag can be good to give your pot a little wipe out or a clean out, as well as being nice and protective to this inner anodised layer when you're packing up everything. The base of the MiniMo as well will pop off. And I'm not sure if you can see here, but on the inside, there's a couple of measurement increments. So you can use this if you're rehydrating dehydrated food. You can measure your water on here. This can also double as a small bowl or potentially even a cup if you want to drink anything out of that. But speaking of drinking anything out of that, the lid itself has these strainer holes here, which allow you to easily drain anything if you're boiling something or draining something or cooking pasta, you know, for example, and you want to drain the water off, you can do that. But it also has a mouthpiece here, so if you position the lid relative to the handles, it's quite easy to just drink straight out of your Jetboil once it cools down a little bit. So the materials of the Jetboil itself are anodized aluminium and a combination of stainless steel on the handles and around the burner shroud. And obviously the base around here, as you can see with the piezo ignition, is plastic. So to pop your Jetboil MiniMo together, what we'll need to do is, I'll pop the lid back on top first. Get your gas canister and screw that directly onto the shroud, directly onto your burner. Oh, as you can hear that gas coming out. And then from there, you'll see on the actual burner shroud, we've got these two little indentations, and they will line up with on the actual shroud. We've got the two little indentation locks here. So they will slip inside over those indentations and then twist, and then that will lock the MiniMo onto the burner shroud itself. So I'm not actually going to crank this one up, but I do have a demo model here that I'll light up in a minute and show you. But before I do that, the pot support that comes with the MiniMo, as I mentioned before, it gives you a little bit of flexibility if you don't always want to just use your burner with the actual MiniMo flask itself. Your pot support has these little arms that will swing out like so. And that just will nest straight on top of the, you'll see on the, I should show you here, these little slots on the base of these pot arms. They will sit over the edge of the MiniMo metal rim or the burner rim. And that will allow you to, I've got this little pot here, as you can see, sit a range of different pots on there. So I think the Jetboil skillet is nearly about a 20 centimeter in diameter option, so that will sit perfectly on there as well. So this is our demo model, which I will light up for you in a second, but I'm going to take it off the shroud here for a couple of reasons. I've done that a bit delicately because I've pre-filled it with water there too. So I'll put the pot support on And as you can see, those little ridges, they just click into place on the edge of the canister there. So it can get a little bit of muscle to get that third one on, because they do lock on nice and tight, make sure the canister and the stabiliser don't ever separate. So we've got that one in place here. Now, up close, you'll see we have our paddle. It's got a small plus and minus on it. So this is what we're going to be using to turn the gas on and off. And around the other side here, this little section is the mini regulator inside the stovehead. And on this side, we have our little black piezo button, which I'm not sure if you'll be able to see the spark if I press that now. Yeah. So if you do have a jet boil and the piezo's not quite igniting the gas, just triple check this little wire here is bent down enough, because sometimes they can bend up a little bit higher. You ideally want this to sort of be, close to a 45 degree angle to down towards the surface of the gas burner part there. So I'm going to turn the burner on. So Jetboil's instructions do say to get your burner flame cranking before you put your pot on top. So I'm going to turn that on now. You'll hear the gas coming through. Now we're going to crack the piezo. And there we get our flame. Now, whilst the flask or the pot is off, I'll give you a quick idea of how well this flame can simmer, because this does, the MiniMo out of all of the stoves does have pretty exceptional or superior simmer control. Because the pot is shorter and wider, it is a good intermediary between the taller, narrower, like boiling water flasks and a shorter cooking pot. So if you do want to cook food in that pot, you do have some ability to do so. So I'm turning it down now from quite high, and we'll see. There we go, it's starting to drop now. All right, so as you can see, that's dropping down really very low. So when you do ignite the MiniMo, it can take quite a few turns to get the gas flowing through high enough for the piezo to ignite. And that's purely because the simmer control is so sensitive, it allows you to turn it right down when you're actively cooking. So up, too far down, we've gone out now. So let's light it up again, and we'll pop the flask on and boil some water. So the MiniMo has a total of 6,000 BTU. So it does burn quite hot. We're gonna line up those little indents and lock the pot into place. Now I'm gonna quickly start my timer, because Jetboil do claim that about 500 mils of water will take 2 minutes and 15 seconds to boil. So the pot itself has a capacity of a litre, but there is a small indentation on the inside of the pot, which I can actually probably show you before the water gets too hot. That little indicator mark there where I filled the water up to, that's around about your 700 mils, and that's probably the maximum of where you want to fill up your water when you're actively boiling. When the water does get to a rolling boil, obviously it's going to bubble, so we don't want to bubble over and spill out of the lid at the top here. The Jetboil MiniMo also will use around about 100 grams of gas per hour. So this little canister that I have here is a 100 gram canister, and that will give you 1 hour of total use. So if we're thinking boiling about half a liter of water takes around 2 minutes, it means for 100 gram canister of gas, you'll get around about 30 boils of half a liter of water, which gives you a bit of an idea of how much gas it's gonna use up. So the water's finished boiling now, and according to my watch, we're around about 3 minutes and 20 seconds. So I'm gonna turn that gas off, and I'm gonna just let it sit for a little second before I peel the lid off. So Jetboil's claim of around about 500 mils for 2 minutes 15, that was 700 mils for about 3 minutes 20. So it's roughly an extra minute for that additional 200 mils of water. So I'm going to carefully peel the lid off. Now, you can obviously see that I'm touching the Minimo and it's not burning me, even though we know this water just finished a rolling boil. So that is due to this neoprene sleeve that runs the whole way around the flask. Now, it's definitely still quite warm to touch, but it's not anything that's going to burn me. Just be mindful, though, that anything below that neoprene is going to be really burning hot. So from here, if you were to have cooked something or something you want to drink straight out of it, there's no need for you to remove the lid at all. You can even use that to tip or pour into an existing cup. You've got your tea bags and things like that waiting. Or as I said before, you can strain the water off through this little straining section here, but I'm gonna lift it up so you can have a look. So as you can see, the Minimo, it does have that much wider pot base. I mentioned before that you can cook in it, and whilst you can, I don't necessarily mean, or I'm not referring to frying onions and then, you know, chucking your carrots and peas and actively like cooking in it like you would, because it has that anodised aluminium inside. You've got to be careful that you're not scratching it or getting stuff stuck to the inside of the pot that requires you to scrub really hard. So things like potentially rice, if you get it from supermarket partially cooked or pre-cooked or something like that on your lightweight adventures, you wouldn't have trouble with. But if you want to rehydrate foods or cook foods, it's better to put in some water first, boil that up, and then add your solids in afterwards. Just be really mindful of keeping it on a low simmer as well. That's about it for the Jetboil MiniMo, which I have in my camp stash, and I wouldn't be without it. You can get it at snowys.com.au at our lowest prices every day. If you found this video helpful, give us a like. If you've got any questions or comments, chuck them below. You can head here to subscribe or here for more helpful videos.